Langhorne Super Welterweight Division. We've got Paddy Duffy fighting out of SBG, taking on Anthony McCabe out of IFS. McCabe is in the white trunks. Duffy is in the grey. Your referee in the cage is Mr. Aaron Wallace. Three 3-minute rounds here at Clan Wars 37.
Paddy Duffy may be 0-0 as an amateur mixed martial artist, but he does have two novice bouts under his belt, both of which finished within 10 seconds, earning him the nickname in the gym, One Punch.
McCabe's got to be wary of that and keep that head out of danger. And
needs to be wary of the guillotine right in front of us here.
Neck straight away.
McCabe could sneak out the back, but he needs to straighten up his back.
Looking for that trip.
There it is. Has the double underhooks, maybe looking to get that trip on the outside leg.
So already Paddy Duffy is in unknown territory. We've reached past that 10-second marker. And smart work by McCabe to enclose and keep him tight against the cage here.
In the 50-50 position now, but both men have an underhook. Beautiful
knee.
That
right hand is landed by McCabe. Two for good measure.
And back into the middle with the knee. I would like to
Duffy
see him.
Duffy looking to land it right of his own, but big shots coming from McCabe.
McCabe trying to get out of there early, but Duffy fires back.
Duffy's doing well to roll a little. A spin and back fist landed a little unorthodox, but it did land.
You can already see the marking up on the body from those knees and kicks.
Both fighters just on the break of the clinch. Where you're susceptible, just a clash of the heads there as he was coming in, but susceptible to big shots and drags him to the ground as Anthony McCabe.
McCabe could take the back here. Duffy wisely turns into him. Let's see just how good a ground game McCabe has. Inside the close guard, but
big,
right
big strikes.
Big round of power from McCabe. Freeman off, lands him big.
Just postured up and rained down some punishment. Big right hands and being smart, Phil. He's not just emptying the well with shots here as well. He's waiting and posturing up and shot selection.
And right now is where I'd like to see him posture. Needs to be wary of leaving the arms in. Duffy doing the right thing with that knee shield, mate. Perhaps even looking for a Google bladder there. Needs to be wary of the up kick.
Okay, crowding, trying to crowd, stack the legs and get back in.
Does the right thing.
But high intensity here starting this one off as well.
You have to wonder just how sustainable a pace like this is, Noel.
And again, the nervousness, Phil, the adrenaline flowing, adrenaline dumps happen in fights, and both fighters have started high octane action here.
McCabe momentarily had side control. Duffy wise to it, gets the half guard back.
The big man submission is there. That arm triangle, a favorite of mine when I was practicing jiu-jitsu, but abandons it and looks to posture up and land shots as well. While Duffy is just trying to get that knee shield and shrimp. He's got to be careful of his back being taken.
McCabe doing the right thing by only really allowing Duffy space with which he wants to give him, only allowing him the space he wants to give him to turn his back, to give up his back, posturing appropriately. And very intelligent work from the young IFS man. Big hammer fist.
There's the clapper as well, so we know we can let the gas tank go a little here.
These are big shots. The closing stances of the rounds.
Most of the headshots were blocked there by Duffy, but a big opening round for Anthony McCabe. Started off, looked like we're going to be in a grappling exchange, and then I was like, let's forget this and just throw fists at each other.
They were absolutely winging shots, but then McCabe was able to score the takedown, and from there, that's really where he did his best work, Noel O'Keefe.
A few highlights here from the first round of Clan Wars MMA, and look again, this is where we thought the guillotine was the opportunity there. Done well to fight through it and stay away, Phil. The right things, again.
See, they both have that over under, but very much a 50-50 position. Smart work from McCabe to break, and that's where he landed. The beautiful strikes on the ground.
Shots coming from the hip here as well. Big knee. And it was almost like Duffy wasn't ready for that firefight coming back and tries to fire back his own, but good shots. And this is where the end of the round was. The big hammer fist on top by the IFS man. Anthony McCabe will be feeling comfortable. Only his second fight at MMA. He took his first fight, Phil, on 2 days. Notice
all the way back in November 2016, coming away with a 16-second armbar win. So both these guys haven't spent a lot of time inside the cage. This is the deepest water they have been in their short mixed martial arts careers.
Here we go once again. Just McCabe is in the white and Duffy is in the gray, and a beautiful
big
uppercut.
Uppercut
both landed there, but The bigger shot probably coming from McCabe. Utilizes the dirty box and a nice right hand. Landed there by Duffy on the inside. But
I think he's wobbled him a little bit.
It is Duffy who's backed against the cage. Maybe separation and continue with the hands may be the best option.
Again, McCabe looking for that double underhook trip. Just wearing on his opponent right now, giving himself a little bit of time to catch his breath. Working those double underhooks. In a position like this, I'd like to see Duffy clamp down with the Whizzer. Just abandons it. Again, big knee to the middle from McCabe. Maybe in on a single here. May go for the high crotch.
Just looking almost to kick that lead leg away. And McCabe turns in. Got to watch the neck here.
That's a beautiful single leg from Duffy. Duffy turned the pipe on it expertly. Landing in the mount position.
As well. This is a big position. Rolls credit to McCabe. He's got to get out the back door. Sheer brute strength by Anthony McCabe just to get out of there.
Needs to be wary of the armbar. Stack pass.
Just I think Duffy might look back in that moment and regret. He rushed a little, Phil, just a little, and that allowed Anthony McCabe to exploit it.
McCabe, that head-arm triangle is there should he get across the body. Needs to clamp down with his head, abandons it. Decides it's not an option for him right now. But in just a dominant position, keeping the hips nice and low. Duffy trying to do the right thing by turning in towards McCabe.
Just coming past the halfway point of the second round here. And McCabe again finds himself in the favourable position on top. And it's more so up to Paddy Duffy to better this here, as in McCabe will happily work away here, Phil.
Duffy as I switches say that, to
Duffy
the single.
Up for the single. Apologies, Phil, talking across you, but just worked up for the single. What does he need here to turn the tables for the judges, I suppose, if anything?
Well, he scores a beautiful takedown there, but what he needs to do is he needs to land some ground and pound in these kinds of positions, because we've seen McCabe land the ground and pound. That's been the most telling moment of the fight for me. Duffy needs to show that he's capable of doing just as much.
Looking to use that strength to switch, but potential. Duffy remains on top.
Potential for a bump sweep there. McCabe trying to get in on a guillotine now. May use this as a little bit of a lever to get himself back to his feet.
Use
needs
the cage
to base off.
And that grab as well, and that grappling tip. Maybe get back to his feet.
Needs to base off. Needs to plant a hand down, then a knee, and start working his way up. Potential to come out the back, but again, Duffy needs to take his time taking the back this time. Remember what happened last time. Good awareness.
That looked to the head. Aaron Wallace stepped in.
I think that may have been to the body. I'm not sure. I think if we need to see a replay of that, but that to me initially looked like a knee to the body. We
Aaron
need
Wallace
to see that again.
Just stepped in, and Aaron Wallace is just calling in the medics here. And again, I don't think it was malicious by McCabe. It looked like he was choosing a shot. It looked like he was directing it. Here's a replay. Let's have a close look.
Again, that looks
like it potentially could be the chest.
It's inconclusive. We're going to need to see that slowed down. There we see the position.
May have grazed the chin. You can certainly see in McCabe's favor here. He was selecting his target. Potentially may have hit the chest and ricocheted and hit the chin. But Anthony McCabe, for me, was shot selection was chest there. He was aware of it. So our medics are just looking at Paddy Duffy here. He will have time, but hopefully, again, he is able to continue, because I'm thoroughly enjoying this fight, Phil.
Even after seeing that replay three times, we're watching it here cage side. We've seen it three times, and it's relatively inconclusive to us.
That's a great point. And for Aaron Wallace, was, of course, an exceptional referee, was close to the action. Yeah. He may have seen a better view than we have with it. He's going to speak to Duffy, and this is a point deduction, and this, Phil, could be huge. We could potentially be one round apiece.
Yeah.
And now we're looking at he's losing the fight.
And you have to say a big well done, and give credit to Duffy. He had an out of the fight there.
100%.
Chose not to take it.
A lot of fighters would.
I really respect that. So hats off to Duffy for staying in the fight and choosing to do it in the most admirable fashion.
And as we say, Aaron Wallace was a lot closer and seemed to have a better angle than potentially the cameras did there. As you said, Phil, three times we watched it and it was inconclusive. And that brings an end to the second round. Plenty of action.
A show of respect from both men. Anthony McCabe just intimating that should that have been an errant knee, he didn't mean it. But again, this puts this fight on an absolute knife edge.
Yeah.
For me, this is bound to light a fire for Anthony McCabe. He's bound to go in there knowing that he needs a finish to win this fight in the third round. There we see a lovely single from Duffy.
Beautiful. McCabe is...
A And here we see the knee again.
One more time. See, it's the way I look at it, Phil, from what I can imagine Aaron Wallace might be saying, he's thrown the knee with his left knee.
Yeah.
And the trajectory of the knee was going towards the head. It's that angle.
Yeah.
So potentially he could have caught the chest first, but the follow through could have allowed
May have traveled up. Yeah, that's a
great
point.
When you look at the angle of the knee, potentially that could be on the jawline.
And you can see the position of Aaron Wallace. Aaron Wallace is so much better placed than you or I sitting here.
Yeah.
Showing what a good referee he is by getting into that position in the first place.
Yeah.
So he's seen something there.
I agree there. I think it wasn't intentional.
Yeah.
But potentially the angle that the knee was thrown carried onto the head. So excellent work on our two cameramen standing on top of the cage, and of course to Aaron Wallace in the cage. So this all of a sudden is not a more interesting round, but we know that potentially that was a 9-9 round now. So 100%, this is all to play for in the third round.
Nice side kick to maintain distance. Catches the kick. Can Duffy get the takedown? Rushes McCabe towards the cage.
Great strength by McCabe on his feet. Paddy Duffy rushed him there, but McCabe manages to stay upright. And he's looking to take it down there. Beautiful
trip. But again, beautiful use of the wizard to get back to his feet. McCabe showing he has no fear throwing those knees
again. In on the guillotine.
That looks tight, standing guillotine. Duffy looks like he may just pop the head out.
Made the adjustments there, McCabe.
Oh, that looks super tight. May choose to pull guard on it. He has the leverage. Duffy pops out. How tough.
Big uppercut landed by McCabe. Duffy's a wobbly legs. Goes for the knee. Just misses. But Duffy chases down a takedown. Big heavy hands on top by McCabe.
The resilience of Duffy is unbelievable. And on a single himself, scores
it to the mat. This is insane. Paddy Duffy somehow is staying in this fight and in on a single. McCabe sprawls and is in the top position.
Trying to pop the head down and land strikes of his own. Trying to isolate a wrist, maybe looking for a reach over Kimura. Needs to sprawl heavy and hard right now. Needs to kick those legs out from behind him. You don't want to give Duffy the upper. There it is. You don't want to give Duffy the chance for that single. Good sprawl.
Good work by McCabe. Now looking to work away around. A little knee to the body just to soften Duffy up as he moved. Duffy reaching in there again.
What he may try and do is try and pull Duffy forward to give an opportunity to get his hooks in. But again, he's trying to get in on that guillotine. Trying to isolate a wrist. May take the back here if he can get a hook in.
Working his way around to the back.
The hook on the right side is open for him. Should he choose to take it, that hook is there. Duffy wise to it, turtles up.
Excellent work by McCabe, though, Phil. Every time he moves, he works. He doesn't just move and sit. He's constantly getting his position, landing big shots. And that's making Paddy Duffy change with the shots that are landing on top.
Aaron Wallace is taking a long, hard look at this with the volume of ground and pound being landed by McCabe.
Dedicating this fight to young Owen Hamill is Anthony McCabe, and he is giving it his all here tonight.
What a tribute of a performance this young man is playing right now.
And Phil, potentially the point deduction has made him come out an angry, eager, hungry man in the third round.
That's what I was saying at the beginning of the round. The emphasis really lay with him to go out and make something happen. And that's what he's doing in a very dominant fashion. Firstly, with the submission attempt, now with that grinding wrestling and ground and pound. Coming up to the 10-second clapper.
Goes by the monocle, Grim Reaper. Goes Anthony McCabe, and it looks like he could be claiming a victim here in the form of Paddy Duffy. What a performance. Both men left it all in the Clan Wars cage. We're going to go to the judges' scorecards, but Phil, recap us through some of the highlights of this great contest.
There we see the guillotine. As you said, Anthony McCabe made the adjustment. It looks super tight, but Paddy Duffy showing he's a toughie with some beautiful, beautiful resilience. He even comes in and scores that single leg of his own. What I think just pipped it in a very close contest was the cardio of McCabe. I think perhaps Paddy Duffy, that being the longest he spent in the cage, the gas tank was a little bit depleted, and Anthony McCabe just continued to pour it on with some beautiful ground and pound. It'll be interesting to see if that point deduction changes the ebb and flow of this decision, but a fantastic fight here at Clan Wars 37 from the Crown Plaza.
appreciation for both fighters. After three rounds of action, we go to your judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout 29-27. For your winner, by unanimous decision, fighting out of the blue.